Bandi Posala Cheruva and Bithur, which is a place near Kanpur, where they have identified some arc colored pottery, OCP they say in archaeology, they have identified all of these things, where Rama lived, where Rama transports. Apart from that, there is also a place known as Ganeshwara in Rajasthan. There is also a place in the Balagari, which is known as Mahagara in Uttar Pradesh, where there are archaeological evidences which support the lineage of Rama. You should understand that is Surya Vamshasthiye, not exactly of Rama. If you say Rama, then you will get into the Yuga conflict, you will get into innumerable conflicts of the Vansha dynasty. There will be a very great clash that is going to happen. So that which is, for example, Shankaracharya Kritam means, we have filtered most of the books as concluded by somebody Shankaracharya in the Pita, like Shivananda Gali, this thing, etc. They cannot be concurred along with that of the coincidence of Prasthanatraya Bhashya of the original Shankaracharya. So whenever you get something, it may be out of the lineage of the person, dynasty of the person, or the reminiscences of any other person following the tradition, or a tributary, it should be there. So he has identified. Moreover, this S.R. Rao, he has quoted one thing. All the Vanaras are monkey-like people who are there living in the Neolithic area. According to even history, so it is known as Abhyugamyavadari. Even if I accept you, I can refute you. So I have already told them I cannot accept history. Even if I accept history, you cannot stand before me, is the rule now. Even if you accept archaeology, these type of excavations from Hampi, Parsur Patta, Kursur Patta, then Bandi Kursur Cheru, all these places, it proves that there was a Ikshvaku lineage. And the Neolithic people who existed at the time of people, at the time of these Ramayana, they were none but the Vanaras who have been preserved because of their faith. Now also we are seeing lot of children in a house who are functionally similar to Hanuman, and we are seeing lot of people in the society who can be very hardly distinguished from the Hanuman-like creatures. So it is also existing now. Why can't it be there before several millennium or centuries? It may be possible from that. Apart from that, you should understand B.P. Lal, who has published the archaeological survey report for Ramayana's existence. That survey report has told 5 archaeological sites. He is not a believer of Rama, he is not a religious person. He told that I cannot fully accept, but there is a kernel of truth, and I cannot say that it is a fictional construction. 5 archaeological sites have been surveyed by the person, and he has reported in 1975, archaeological site of India, it has launched 14 Kasauti style of a stone pillar basis. It has launched, it is kept in, it has been kept in silence, buried in silence without reporting and without mentioning the same thing to the public who are enthusiastic to know about Rama. It has been concealed inside. So it is archaeological survey report. He wrote about Sri Lanka. Sri Lankan government, Ministry of Tourism, they have made a committee. It is known as Ramayana Trailer Executive Committee. So you know about the foreign exchange. You give your money and get that money. Cultural exchange, like that quality exchange has happened between India and Sri Lanka. Sri Lankan people, they believe in Ravana and Rama, and these people where Rama was born, they don't believe at all. So the Ravana qualities have come to this administration and Rama qualities have gone there as a project of cultural exchange or foreign exchange. In which there was a very great person known as N.C.K. Kirilin. N.C.K. Kirilin is the director of this project. Recently he visited India and various departments. He addressed about the existence of Rama. They have published a book which I have to present to everybody. It is known as not merely Ramayana and Ravana, Ramayana and historical Ravana. Ravana proved by history. So Anuradhapura, Lagalla and Sikiriya, innumerable places like Sita Gufa, Sita Vati, Ashoka Vati, Ravana Falls, innumerable places they have identified and they have published it. And what he has mentioned is, it is a genuine incident. Ramayana is a genuine incident, but unfortunately we don't have vital evidences. The available evidences should be converted into history at all. Innumerable things he has suggested about Bharadwaja, existence of Rishi Sringa, existence of Vasishta, Vishwamitra, they are not evidences to Ramayana. See, there are two things. One is proof and something to be proved. If Rama is to be proved, if you say that Vishwamitra is also there, he also told, he is also one among the elements to be proved, he is not a proof. So history is entirely different by giving proofs. History has innumerable other dimensions. Even if you quote Sankhya Sautra Sutra, the first reference of Rama is in the Vedas. Pradapate Shicharati Gadhe Antaha, he entered into the womb of a mother and he is born. And even in Yajurveda, there is a very direct representation. Rishayova Pratyaksham Indram Napashyan Tam Vasishtam Pratyaksham Apashyat. Here Indra Shabda denotes to Vishnu, Iti Parameshwariya Dhatu. So here, according to Yoga, nobody has seen that Brahman by Tapas. Whereas Vasishtha has seen that particular Brahman Vishnu. So the Lord told in the Yajurveda Kriti Kanda, the Lord tells Vasishtha that making you as a Purohita, I am going to be born in the solar dynasty. That's why in Ramayana, Vishwamitra says, Vasishthopi Mahatejaha, Yecheve Tapasistita. So there are innumerable proofs, but there are internal evidences. Number two, even if you say that there, W.L. Smith is a very great research scholar on Ramayana impact on Thailand, Laos, Cambodia, East Asia, Southern Asia. That is also not a proof. That is a validated proof of the impact of Ramayana in art form, basic belief, religious infiltration. That is a proof for impact, not for the abomination or authenticity of the story. And all the characters that you mention is also not a proof. They are also yet to be proved along with the Rama. They are also standing in queue so that they should be proved. So the exact proof is a little different. First is the place. Rama has crossed innumerable places, you know, that starting from Ayodhya, Mithila, and there is even at Nepal, there is a place known as Sita Marhi, where Sita was exactly born. And she has crossed Lumbini while coming back. And 249 BC, there was an edict of the Ashoka pillar. Ashoka has made a pillar and edict in which they have measured and marked the arrival of both Buddha as well as Rama and Sita. For 249 BC, that is also the evidence in which the belief of the arrival of Rama that existed there. Then they came into innumerable places like Panchavati. He has told about Panchavati, how tourists are misled and misguided. So innumerable places, starting from that place, they have come to Panchavati, then Rishyamsa Parvata, then Dharushkoti, Sri Lanka, innumerable places. They reside at these places, and some sort of additional proof with our belief and followership that should be taken. And in the conclusion, I want to say 6 major rules for bringing out the real Rama in the society, not only in the society as a historical evidence, but also an inner evidence. You have to bring Rama inside. When Rama is inside safe, outside he can be believed, he will be properly worshipped, and his glory and rule will withstand. To bring Rama inside is the only way to bring Rama outside. Number one, what you have to do? The first thing is, you should bring out all the archaeological findings. He has told that we have got a lot of collections of archaeological findings. So hidden archaeology, forbidden archaeology, conspiracy and archaeological findings made by J.E. Stelling is a very famous book which we have to read. So number one, rule number one, we have to bring all findings and publish it in the net, made available for all people. The second thing is, we have to get into advanced methodologies of going beyond 60 meters in archaeological findings. That is not the letters. Radar detection, then distant collision methods, satellite detection methods, extant photography methods, Korba photography methods, nano photography methods. These things are to be brought in order to understand the real things. Third thing is very important. The person should be impartial and unbiased. It is not that there is not a thesis because of the minority, those who are integrally majority, there is a fear of vote bank and vote supply, and people cannot take courageous measures for bringing out the real truth. That is a problem in the society. Even if you have science, even if you have all stuff and substances with you, if you don't have courage, if you are biased inside your mind, you cannot bring truth at all. Truth will be always here, hidden door, and you have distant star and you cannot bring it. Number fourth thing is very important. You have to research on Ramayana in a historical perspective. It is known as archaeohistory or historioarchaeology, ancient history, historiography, antohistoriology, innumerable things are there. Then somebody in one lecture, they asked me to prove Rama within a single statement. I told one thing. You see, you need not prove the things. If you prove the proof, you can get the validation of the primary element. So, Gyaneshwara, Tukaram, Samarthadasa, Ramadasa, Kaviramadasa, Bhadrachala Ramadasa, Kanakadasa, Purandaradasa, Tulasidasa, Tyagaraja, innumerable composers are there, innumerable saintly people are there, those are envisioned Rama, experienced Rama, aesthetically coincident with Rama, they are true. If they are true and historically proved, automatically their experience is true. If their experience is proved, unless the subject and object of the experience is true, how their experience is true? So history proves the hagiography, the visibility of saintly people. Saintly people are proved by which their experience is proved, by which a supra-historical proof, by which Rama is believed to be true because of the believers are true. Their belief and experience and impact is true. They have composed innumerable things. They have created a very great mass transformation in the society. Considering this hagiographic influence, we have to conclude that as all the great devotees, it is not like we are naming Rama. We can name anything else. We can name Rama. We can name the sweets in Rama. That is not there. Great persons, ecstatic, ecclesiastical and transcendental personalities, they have rejoiced Rama just as we are rejoicing food and jaggery. They have rejoiced Rama, mingled and merged with Rama, and they have given their experiences. They are flawless, they are totally the embodiment of transcendental truth. As they are all truth, the object of that truth, Rama itself, should be nothing but the personification of truth and nothing else. The problem in the society is, as everybody is saying, if there is a thief, immediately he will see the other person as a thief only. We are all incomplete. So it is very difficult to accept a person who is complete in our mind at all. Then Mahatma Gandhi was assassinated. John Bernard Shaw told that after 100 years, people won't believe that such a person existed. And number two, when the Nazi victims are photographed by the British army commander told, you have to release the photographs, otherwise some scholar or scoundrel will say that this thing did not happen. On all concentration camps, heaps of dead bodies have been photographed and published in satellites. He told that after few years, some scholar may say that it was not true. So we are all incomplete. So it is very difficult for us to believe a Purna Purusha. If God resides inside us, really we can do all of the wonders. So the sixth rule to believe Rama is to develop an attachment towards the scriptures and to instill culture and heritage. If there is purity, you can get clarity in thought. If there is clarity, you can get true knowledge. True knowledge reveals the real sense of culture and heritage. Culture and heritage reveal in the true sense that gives you religious understanding. Religious understanding gives you spiritual maturity. Spiritual maturity makes you not to search for Rama. It will make Rama to search for you and set it in your heart forever. That is the sixth rule. And I believe that we should make a campaign to create Rama. If there is no Rama, then we have to remove honesty, tranquility, liberation, eternity, perfection, precision. All words have to be removed from the dictionary. Rama is not a mythological character. Rama is not an Indian character. He is the personification of fulfillment and fullness of human endeavor. If you want to have a goal for your life, role model of your life, destination of your life, if you want to start your life, start with Rama. Conduct your life, conduct with Rama. Reach somewhere else, reach Rama. So he is the part and parcel of each and everybody's life, and taking the Rama's mission is nothing but taking human mission for perfection into humanity, then entering into divinity. So let us take this mission, which is very much urgent. Because of lack of Rama knowledge only, the whole world is suffering from global warming, terrorism, and all ugly effects. Let us reinstall Rama in the minds of the people, in the intellect of the people, in the real historical perspective and para-historical experience, and also in the books, also in the way of behavior and attachment to society, as a good role model for civilianship, domesticship, personalship, as well as a global citizenship, by making the whole world to be in a real manner in which it was at the time of the creation of God, how God exemplifies this world to be. Let us make this noble mission to reach all corners of the society in a very effective manner, so that we can bring Rama Rajya, being ruled by the representatives of Rama, even not directly by Rama. Narayana, Narayana.